My dear students, today we are going to see about the parasitism. It is one of the negative interaction. Already we have seen predation. Predation is one of the negative interaction. The parasitism also is one of the negative interaction. In the negative interaction, two organisms are interacting with each other. One is benefited, another one is harmed. That we have studied in the predation. In parasitism also, it is an interaction between the two different species in which one organism is benefited, most benefited, and other organism is harmed. Parasitism is the interaction between the two different species in which the smaller partner, that we say it is the parasite, that obtains food from the larger partner, that is called host. So smaller partner is called parasite, larger partner is called host. The parasite will get food materials, water, minerals, everything from the host organism. This is parasitism. It is of two types. There are two types of parasite. What is a parasite? When a living organism found growing other living organism for food materials, for water, for minerals, for shelter, that is called parasite. There are two types of parasite based on the host and parasite relationship. The parasitism is classified into two types. They are number one, holoparasite, and number two, heavy parasite. Holoparasite, it is a interaction between the two organisms. Here, one is benefited, another one is harmed. The organism depend on the host plants for entire nutrition. They are called total parasite or holoparasite. Holoparasites are parasites which are fully depend on the entire nutrition from the host organism. That is holoparasite. What is holoparasite? It is a type of parasite in which the parasitic organism depends on the host organism for entire nutrition. That is called holoparasite or total parasite. Total parasite is of two types, total stem parasite and total root parasite. Total stem parasite is a parasite which is found growing on the stem of host organism. But the total root parasite, it is a parasite which is found growing on the root of host organism. So there are two examples given for total parasite. One is total stem parasite, another one is total root parasite. Cascuta is a total stem parasite found growing on the stem of acacia, duranta, and many other plants. Balanophora, arobanch, rafflesia are the total root parasite found growing on the root of higher plants. So for total stem parasite, for total root parasite, examples are given. Diagrammatic structure also given in the book. PS of host along with cascuta. This is the host plant. This is the parasitic plant. This is the host plant. The parasitic plant having connection with the host plant, the stem of the host plant through haustoria. This is the haustorial connection. They are haustoria or the root-like structures produced from the parasitic organism in order to absorb water, food materials, minerals from the host organism. They are very essential. Astoria are very essential in order to absorb food materials, water, minerals, everything from the host organism. That's why parasitic organism send the root-like structure called Astoria, and these Astoria connect with the vascular bundles, both xylem and phloem. As far as total parasite is concerned, the Astoria will have connection with the xylem and phloem of the vascular bundles of the stem of the host organism. So that is the structure given at the point of contact. Section is taken. This is the host stem, parasitic stem. In between host stem and parasitic stem, there are Astoria will have connection with the both xylem and phloem. So that is the cascota twining around the stem of the host organism. This is root parasite Arobanch growing on the root of brinjal plant, Solanum melangina. This is the Solanum melangina brinjal plant. The root of Solanum melangina is having connection with the root of Arobanch. That's why it is called total root parasite. It is found growing on the root of the host organism, that is brinjal plant, and get water, food materials, minerals, everything from the root of the host organism through Astoria. So that is about the holoparasite. Come to the hemiparasite. Hemiparasite is a type of parasite which is found growing on the stem or root of host organism to get water and minerals only from the host organism. The organism which obtain only water and minerals from the host plant for the synthesis of food by photosynthesis, they are called hemiparasite. Between total parasite and hemiparasite, we can say at least two differences. In the case of total parasite, the total parasite will get all the nutrients from the host organism, that is food materials, water, minerals, all from the host organism, fully depend on the host organism. Whereas the hemiparasite will absorb, will obtain only water and minerals from the host organism. That is the one first difference. Second, the Astoria of the total parasite will have connection with the host organism with xylem and phloem. Astoria is connected with the xylem as well as phloem. As far as total parasite or holoparasite is concerned, because to get water from the xylem, to absorb food materials from the phloem. That's why the Astoria of the total parasite connected with the xylem and phloem of the vascular bundle of the total host organism. That is the another difference. In the case of hemiparasite, the Astoria of the hemiparasite having connection with the vascular xylem of the vascular bundle of the host organism. So these two are the differences, you have to keep it in your mind. As far as hemiparasites are concerned, two examples are given. One for one for partial stem parasite, another one for partial root parasite. Viscum and Loranthus are partial stem parasite, whereas Sandalum album, Sandanamaram, Sandalum album, sandalwood tree is a partial root parasite. So that is about holoparasite and hemiparasite. Come to the competition. Competition is the interaction between the two organisms or two species in which both the organism or species are harmed. In the case of predation and also parasitism, one organism is benefited, another organism is harmed. But here in competition, both the organisms are harmed. It is the severest in population that has irregular and distribution. Irregular distribution they have. It is also two types. Competition is also two types. One is intra-specific competition. Second one is inter-specific competition. In the intra-specific competition, there is an interaction between the same species. Here interaction is taking place between the same species. So intra-specific interaction is a type of interaction between the two organisms of the same species. It is very severe because all the members of the species have similar requirements of food, habitat, and pollination, etc. They have similar adaptation to fulfill their needs. So these are all the characteristic features of intra-specific competition. Come to inter-specific competition. It is the interaction between the individual and the two different species. It is the interaction between the individuals of two different species. In grassland, many species of grasses grow well because there is very little competition when enough nutrients and water is available. Here, survival in both the competition is determined by the quality of nutrients, availability of water, and migration to new areas. So these are all the factors determine the survival in both the competition. Different species of herbivores, larvae, and grasshopper competition, they compete for fodder or forage plants. Here, different species of herbivores, larvae, and grasshopper competing for fodder or forage plants. So that is all about the competition. Now, in this class, we have studied about the parasitism, two types of parasitism. There are two types of parasite, holoparasite and gummy parasite. Then competition, there are two types of competition, intra-specific competition and inter-specific competition. That is all about the negative interaction. That is all.